everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to go through the arrays and strings. From now we have talked about the variables of single length, a single variable, a single digit, which is the one element array. But arrays of the arrays are many variables of the same type are gathered in one variable. For example, int a of 3 allocated a space of 3 elements array named A with integer type. All of them has the same type. A of 3 is a vector of 3 elements, and the elements index begins from 0, means that if we have declared int A of 3, A of 0 is the first element, A of 2 is second element, and A of 3 is third or the last element. We can declare int A clam, which is the undefined length vector, and the program is automatically are going to allocate a non-length space for variable A. We can define matrix, two-dimensional matrix, by declaring int A clam clam, and this is a two-dimensional matrix with undefined length of row and column. But if we use A of 3 of 2, it indicates a matrix with 3 rows and 2 columns. We can also declare a 3-dimensional array with using A clam clam clam, or a n-dimensional array with the definition declaration of A clam clam and so on to clam. This makes C more compatible rather than an other programs. As example, we have a float f, and we initialize the vector with 5 elements of float. We can declare a character of a vector, an array of characters defining by A, B, C inside a double quote, or which is the equivalent to the R vector is equal inside the clam parenthesis A inside the single quote, B inside the single quote, C inside the single quote, and also it must have the end of that string. We are going to talk about it later. And backslash 0 indicates a space after that string or of or the end of string. We can also define all elements as one definition or initialization. We can have a integer, a vector of 100 lengths of integers with all of them 0, which is initialized to 0 all the elements. And the arithmetic of all those variables are the same as we had it before. So I am writing 4s equals single quote A, single quote B, single quote C, and single quote backslash 0, and another variable C, clam is equal F N B, and we are going to print F with format S because they are as a string, and format S new line S and C. Compile it. First one is ABC and the second one is FND. Now we are going to use integers. Integers 1, 2, 3, 4. And okay, it is okay. We are going to printf integer S of 0 multiplied by 15 and S of 2 plus 10, and we are going to run, and as you see the first number is 1 multiplied by 15 and the third element is 3 plus 10 is 30. Okay, now we are going to talk about the strings. String in C is an array of characters, and we have talked about characters which are a single letter, but and a string is a phrase, a meaning, and difference between character and strings is that you must declare or initialize a character in the single quote while you are initialize a string in a double quote. This is that difference. And when you are going to print a single character, you are going to use percent C, and when you are going to print out a string, you are going to write percent S. There are macro program functions like putchar, putc, getS, which take care of only characters, and put S, and yet S, they are handling of strings. And we are going to use all those things when we learn about the loops. And the string is simply a phrase, chair, car, char, character, S. And when you are going to define an string, which is an array of characters, you are going to use the clammer, and inside there you are going to use double quote, welcome to, welcome to, welcome to C programming, and you are going to write and you are going to use S only, and it writes. Welcome to C programming. In C, there is a header file, string.h, and when you are opening that one, that string, I am going to show you, and it is in here. I am going to open it in new window. In new window, and it is program files. And it is in PLC. In PLC, include, and you are going to scroll down, and it is a string dot h string there, string dot h. And you can open it and you can see a lot of functions that we are going to go through when we learn about files. When we go through about the files. Okay, it was in that macros we can even use the put char, put s, and put c, get char, get s, put s, and we are going to use those functions when we have learned about the loop, and also we are going to use a lot of string function when we learn about the files, and a lot about another phrases or another string variables. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.